Hello students, welcome to our YouTube channel all about breaking and making. We have already discussed all four permanent electronic effects. Today we will discuss about the steric effect, that how the bulkiness of a particular molecule can affect its reactivity or its characteristics. So let's see. We will first take an example of coupling reaction. This is NN dimethyl aniline. Okay, so if we had 2H over here, then it would be the normal aniline, but as we have 2 methyl groups in place of 2 hydrogens, that's why it is NN dimethyl aniline. So if we take this diazonium salt as the reagent, which is benzene diazonium chloride, then the coupling usually occurs through the para position like this. So in this step, we can see that this benzene ring has lost its aromaticity. Now in this second step, with the loss of H plus, this will get back its aromaticity. And this is the product. Okay, so this is the para coupling. Now in place of this NN dimethyl aniline, if we have a system like this, then if we apply the same reagent, there will be no coupling reaction. So the difference between these two structures are only here these two are hydrogens and here these two are methyl groups. Now we know that in comparison with hydrogen, methyl group is more bulky. So these methyl groups will interact with each other in such a way that this nitrogen with this lone pair is no longer in the same plane with this pi electron cloud of benzene. As here we can see, the lone pair over this nitrogen is involved in conjugation, thus the coupling takes place in the para position. If this conjugation does not take place, then there will be no chance of this para coupling. And as we get no para coupling product here, it is very clear that there is no conjugation. Now why there is no conjugation? These two bulky methyl groups will interact sterically with each other. Thus the coplanarity of this lone pair with this pi electron cloud of benzene moiety is disturbed. They are no longer in the same plane. That's why this type of conjugation here is not feasible and we get no coupling reaction. So due to the presence of these bulky methyl groups, the possibility of para coupling for this substrate has been restricted. So from this example, we can surely have an idea about how the steric factor imparts an important role in the reactivity of that particular molecule. There are electronic factors like inductive effect, mesomeric effect, resonance, hyperconjugation. Like here, also the steric effect plays an important role in controlling the reactivity of a molecule towards a chemical reaction. So this is an example where the reactivity of a particular substrate is influenced by the steric effect. This is nothing but steric effect, which is associated strictly to the bulkiness of the molecule, to the bulkiness of the different structural parts of the molecule. Okay, now let's move to the next example. This is example number 2. This was example number 1. So this is 2,6 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol, and we have also here three 5 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol. So these two structures are basically isomers, but the position of these methyl groups are different in these two. Here two methyl groups are residing in the ortho positions with respect to this OH group, and here these methyl groups are residing in meta position with respect to this OH group. Now if the question is between these two, which one is the more stronger acid? The answer is this 2,6 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol is a much more stronger acid in comparison with 3,5 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol. So in terms of acidity, this is stronger acid, this is weaker acid. We can explain this with the help of the steric effect. Let's see. So this is our first structure, which is 2,6 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol. Here if it releases the proton, then we get its conjugate base. So this is the conjugate base of this acid. Now we will see the stability of this conjugate base. So what we see here, is this, that here we get extended conjugation of this lone pair over this oxygen through the para nitro group. So this is extended conjugation. That means here resonance is very prominent. That's why this conjugate base will be much more stable because of this extended conjugation through para nitro group. Now if we consider the case of the second acid we have taken, it is this 3,5 dimethyl 4 nitrophenol. So after the release of this proton, we will get this conjugate base. This conjugate base. Now here no possibility of extended conjugation through this para nitro group. Now the question is why? Because if this conjugation have to take place, then all this delocalized part which I have drawn here, so this is the delocalized part here. If we try to point out, this is the delocalized part here. So this is the delocalized part here, which I have marked in red. So all these orbitals should reside on a same plane, which is an important criteria of resonance to take place. We have already discussed in the resonance video. Now here, in presence of these two bulky methyl groups, the steric repulsion of these oxygen atoms and these two bulky methyl groups are very extensive. So in order to minimize this steric repulsion, this carbon nitrogen bond will just rotate, and after this rotation, the p orbital over this nitrogen and this benzene pi electron cloud are no longer in the same plane. Here the conjugation will take place like this inside the ring. Conjugation will be restricted within the benzene ring. No extended conjugation takes place, because if there have to be extended conjugation, then this nitro group will also have to take part in conjugation. Only then there will be extended conjugation. Otherwise, there is no meaning of the phrase extended before this conjugation. As because of this steric effect, this p orbital over the nitrogen atom is no longer on the same plane with this benzene pi cloud. So there is no possibility of extended conjugation, unlike the case of here, where this extended conjugation takes place and imparts greater stability to this system. That's why the conjugate base of 2,6-dimethyl-4-nitrophenol is more stable than that of 3,5-dimethyl-4-nitrophenol. That makes the first one a stronger acid than that of the second one. Okay? So, here we have seen that the acidity of a particular molecule is affected by the steric effect. Similarly, we can explain the basicity order between this and this. Here, the explanation of this comparison of basicity between these two molecules will be the similar as the previous comparison of acidity. Now I am giving you some clue. In this molecule, the lone pair over this NH2 nitrogen will take part in extended conjugation through this para nitro group. So there will be extended conjugation. And here, due to this steric effect, there will be no extended conjugation here. So from this, we can have clear idea about the availability of this lone pair over the NH2 nitrogen in both the molecules. And likewise, we can also do the comparison of basicity between them. So I give you this example to try at home, and let me know which one is a stronger Lewis base and why in the comment section. So this was our today's video on the topic steric effect, that how the steric effect governs the reactivity of a molecule. If you liked it, then give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel to watch more similar topic wise videos on chemistry. In this channel, we make videos on the different topic wise concepts of chemistry, which are very useful for the 11-12 students, the JEE or NEET aspirants, as well as for the undergraduate chemistry students. So stay tuned, stay safe. Thanks for watching.